Hello everyone. Today I want to give a brief introduction to vectors, which are really common objects in physics and math. Generally, we can look at vectors in two ways, geometrically and algebraically. In this video, we are going to look at vectors geometrically. Let's go! Vector, represented by a directed line segment, is defined as a quantity that has both magnitude and direction. You may wonder, what is magnitude? Magnitude is the length of a vector. What about the direction? It is where the vector is pointing. Look at the arrow. It can point this way, or this way, or any other ways in the plane or in the space. Now, what does it mean to say two vectors are equal? Can we say two vectors are equal when their magnitudes are the same like regular numbers? The answer is no. Let's see why. Suppose that we have an object, say a star, that's moving in a straight line. We can use this vector to describe the displacement of the star. This displacement is the star's change of position. See that the star changed its position by moving from its initial position to the final position. Now, starting from the same initial position, what if the star had traveled the same distance but in a different direction? Let's say in the opposite direction, then the star could have been here, which is a different final position from the original one. As you can see, the displacements are not equal, and thus the two vectors, even with the same length, are not equal due to pointing in different directions. That raises another question. When can we say that two vectors are the same? We say two vectors are equal if they have the same length and direction. So you see, these two vectors are equal. Now, for two points, P and Q, we can draw a directed line segment from P to Q, and this vector is called PQ, where P is called the tail, or the initial point, and Q is called the head, or the terminal point. Also, I should mention that the length of the vector PQ is denoted by PQ with the two bars on both sides. Another important thing that I want to point out is that when the initial point and terminal point are the same point, then the vector is the zero vector. The zero vector is the only vector with length zero and no specific direction. Now, let's talk about vector operations. One thing we can do to vectors is to scale them. This operation is called scalar multiplication. What we are doing is that we are multiplying a vector by a scaling factor, also called a scalar. For example, given a vector v, 2v is a vector pointing in the same direction as v, but its length is twice as long as v. If we multiply v by 1/3, then we get a vector also in the same direction, whose length is only 1/3 that of v. Then you may ask, what happens when we multiply by a negative scalar? The negative sign of the negative scalar brings the vector to the opposite direction. See that negative v looks like this. Based on this, we can summarize about the directions of a vector and a scalar multiple. Given a non-zero vector v and a scalar c, if c is positive, then zv has the same direction as v. If c is negative, then cv has the opposite direction as v. How do we add vectors? Given two vectors u and v, the triangle law of vector addition states that if you start with u, then put the initial point v at the tip of u, and draw a new vector with its initial point at the tail of u and the terminal point at the head of v, like this, then this new vector is u plus v. Another law of vector addition is called the parallelogram law. What it says is that if you draw u and v so that the initial points are at the same spot and form a parallelogram, then u plus v is the diagonal of the parallelogram. One thing to notice is that its initial point is also at the same spot as u and v. Okay, we have learned how to add vectors. What if we want to subtract? Let's use the same u and v. If we want to find u minus v, we can treat that as u plus negative v, which means that we are adding u, and the opposite of v. Here, we are using the triangle law to do the subtraction. So far, we have looked at vectors geometrically. Next time, we'll talk about vectors algebraically. Stay tuned. If you like this video, please give me a like, subscribe my channel, and share my videos to others. This is Wilson. Thank you for watching. I will see you next time.